Hello there, everybody, and welcome to
Tidbits!
Today I have something pretty special, will likely be the shortest episode of Tidbits. Wow, this is really reflective. Hello, me. How are you doing? We have 10 of these Yu-Gi-Oh! The Movie packs. Now, when I say Yu-Gi-Oh! The Movie, anybody who's remotely into Yu-Gi-Oh! Probably knows more about this than I do. I only recently discovered these. These are from a movie in 2004, and I guess you could receive these packs when you went to go watch the movie. Obviously, it's not 2004, and I did not go see the movie 10 times, so I just picked these up. They only have one card per pack. And my god, these are a pain to open without trying to, you know, damage the card on the inside. There we go. I opened that like nice and clean. Let's go ahead and pull this first card out. And oh, there's actually two things in there. Well, that's back when Shonen Jump was still a thing. I know it is still a thing, but they don't actually print Shonen Jumps anymore. Good god. Yeah, over 350 pages of your favorite Japanese comics, previews of cards, and video games. Yeah, I remember when that was a thing. I still have a giant collection of Shonen Jump magazines. That makes me upset because it's all digital now and nobody cares about all digital. I want to have the physical Shonen Jumps. Anyways, the card we have received is Pyramid of Light. Okay, it's limited edition because it has the movie tag down there. Kind of neat. Alright, let's move on. So here in our next pack, again, trying to open these very carefully because I don't want to risk bending up and damaging the card inside. Because with there only being one, well, I guess there's technically two cards inside the pack. If you try to open it like the normal way, you could risk doing the damage. There we go. Especially with these old boys from back in 2004. Okay, so we have our Shonen Jump insert and okay. Sorcerer of Dark Magic. Again, I'm not an expert on Yu-Gi-Oh! I am still learning, and I've been learning quite a bit. But I can assume that thing is worth a decent amount, maybe. That might be a decent pull. For an attack of 3,200, defense of 2,800, that is not bad at all. Okay, I need to look into how that can actually be implemented. Next pack. It feels weird to call it a pack. I should be saying next card, because, like, it is just one card, which I guess is a nice bonus, like if you went and like saw the movie or whatever, like you get a special promo card. I don't know how many there are in the set or what is necessarily sought after in here, but I know that there are some that are sought after. There is our Shonen Jump insert, and we have Pyramid of Light. Okay, three packs in and we're already getting duplicates. I kind of expected that. Oop. So there is our Shonen Jump insert, and Wadapon! Okay, little one-star 200, 300. I mean, okay. I can kind of see that being useful, but not really with it being so low. Like, I was looking at, like, the actual effect here, and it basically, if it's special summoned to your hand, like, if it added to your hand because of the effect of a spell or whatever else, then it lets you automatically special summon it. But it has, like, 200 and 300 for attack and defense, so not really that useful, in my opinion. Maybe there's some crazy workaround that I don't know about that makes it super useful. Okay, so there's the Shonen Jump insert and Pyramid of Light. Good god. Do we have to get all Pyramid of Lights? Can we please get, like, you know, some good crap? I don't even know if you can, like, pull, like, holos or anything like that out of these, because so far we haven't. But I don't imagine there are too many different kinds of cards, so having not pulled one yet is kind of nuts. Oh, come on. Come out of the thing. There we go. Alright, insert and Pyramid of Light. Good god, can we stop with the Pyramid of Light? Maybe it's useful and I'm complaining about nothing. What's the Pyramid of Light, like, the most sought after card from this? And I'm just like, man, screw this thing. And okay. Blue Eyes Shining Dragon. Okay, get that more in frame, and of course now my camera is trying to overheat. Bad timing. Oh my god, okay. I have a feeling that might be the most sought after thing. I'm gonna let my camera cool down. Bad timing, man. Okay, camera's cooled down. I went ahead and put that in a sleeve. I know it's not quite a proper fitting sleeve because Yu-Gi-Oh cards are somewhat smaller than the cards I usually do. I'm gonna look into buying some form-fit sleeves for Yu-Gi-Oh. I don't really know how big of an option that is. But, okay, I'm excited for the Blue Eyes Shining Dragon. Let's move on. We got three packs left and see, I don't know, is there anything else crazy in the set? Because that Blue Eyes is definitely making me a happy boy right about now. Let's go ahead and see. We have another Sorcerer of Dark Magic. I kind of had it off frame there for a second because I am stupid. Let's see. If we got another Blue Eyes, I won't even be upset. I'm just hoping that we can get, you know, if there is anything else cool in the set, I would like to pull it. There's another Sorcerer of Dark Magic. And lastly, please be something good. We're gonna try and split this pack open without damaging anything. Sun and Jump insert and Wadapon. Okay, so there does not seem to be much in this set. If you give me a second, I will go look up what else in this set and like what is actually sought after from this. So what we managed to get out of the 10 packs, we have, let's see here. Yeah, we have two Wadapons. One, two, three, four. Man, four Pyramids of Light and three Sorcerer of Dark Magic. And then, of course, our beautiful Blue Eyes Shining Dragon. Let me go ahead and do a little bit of research on this. Okay, I did a bit of research. Of course, I had looked this up before whenever I purchased the pack. But I didn't really look too deeply into what's actually in it. And yes, there are only three, well, four cards in the set. So that's our common. Pyramid of Light is also a common, and actually the Sorcerer of Dark Magic is a common as well. And then this is actually our Blue Eyes is actually a super rare, and it's worth about $6 I'm seeing on eBay, somewhere as low as like $5.50. But yeah, okay, I'm not too upset. I'd say for what I paid for these packs, I mean, I definitely got something out of it at the very least, but cool. If you guys enjoyed this little episode of Tidbits, feel free to give the video a like, subscribe down below, check out the main channel, the other Yu-Gi-Oh! Videos I have done on this channel, all the other fun stuff, and hopefully I will see y'all next time. Goodbye!